Hi everyone, welcome to Applied Forensic Research Sciences. I am Kirti Chug, and I'm the member of Applied Forensic Research Sciences. Today I'm here with my new video on the topic lie detection test or polygraph test. So the topic to be covered in this video are introduction of polygraph test, history, objective, principle of polygraph test, its Indian scenario, its legal aspects, its psychological parameters, equipments that are used in this device, stages of examination, and its limitations. So now move on to our topic, polygraph test, or you can say that lie detection test. What is polygraph test? Polygraph test is used to prove the truthfulness of a subject and measure and record various physiological parameters like blood pressure, pulse, respiration and galvanic skin resistance while the subject is asked series of questions. Lie detection test is also known as detection deception. So the next topic is history. The study of physiological method for deception test measures emotional disturbance begins in early 19th century. Earlier, the subject thought to have committed some social wrong were asked to submit an ordeal to their culture. In this ordeal, person's one arm is placed in boiling water or chewing rice or being placed on cruel balancing apparatus. The common belief on those days were that if a person's arm blistered or if he choked on rice or if he swayed the balance, he was presumed to be guilty. Later, in 1985, Lombroso was the first to use scientific tests to determine guilty or innocence by studying the change in blood pressure and pulse rate while questioning criminals. And then Larson and Keeler independently designed instrument with new features to make it more versatile. And in 1945, Johnny Reid observed that muscular activity could change the person's blood pressure to an extent which can affect the accuracy of examiner diagnosis. So, in 1947, Reid introduced a completely revised polygraph technique. Now move on to our next slide, which is objective of polygraph examination. So first is to verify the veracity of statement of suspect, witness and complainant in all type of crime. Second is to replace the third degree method of interrogation and makes the examination more easy. Third one is to examine white collar criminals, economic criminals and cyber criminals. Fourth, to economize the process of investigation by screening large number of suspects by differentiating between guilty and innocent. So what is the principle behind the polygraph test? Polygraph test is based on the principle of psychosomatic interaction with an individual, that is psychologically a change in person consciously held feeling produces a defense reaction in form of physiological changes in blood pressure, respiration, pulse rate, galvanic skin resistance, etc. According to Reid, a fear of detection and entrapment induces a person to lie, which produces such responses. Indian scenario of polygraph test. The polygraph test used in India just for the crime investigation. The polygraph test was introduced in India for the first ever time in Delhi at Central Forensic Science Laboratory under the Crime Bureau of Investigation. And in 1972 or 1973, a fully fledged lie detection division was established. And the lie detection division of CFSL CBI New Delhi has till date furnished opinion in 3,575 cases involving various cases from conventional to white collar crimes. Aspects of polygraph test. First, it deals with the privilege against self-incrimination and it's violated the Article 20 Clause 3, where Article 20 Clause 3 states that no person accused of any offence shall be compelled to be witnessed against himself. Physiological parameters. There are three types of parameters, that is suspect, complainant, and witness, which is broadly classified as truthful and untruthful. Polygraph examination situation can be compared to a gold achievement situation, where both truthful and untruthful person trying to prove their innocence. In this slide, a block diagram is prepared to show the difference between the gold achievement behavior of truthful and untruthful person. Polygraph equipments. First is pneumograph. It is used to record the respiration. Pneumograph is partially inflated rubber tube which is fastened around the thoracic or abdominal region of the examinee. Next is syphygmomanograph. It is a cuff which is fastened around the right arm in such a way that the rubber portion of cuff is placed over the branchial artery for the satisfactory recording of blood pressure and pulse rate. And the third one is galvanograph. In this, electrodes are attached to the index and ring finger of left hand for recording the galvanic skin resistance. And the last one is plethysmograph. It is a transducer which is attached to the thumb and it measures the blood volume reflecting the pulse rate. Now our next topic is stages of polygraphic examination. First stage is pretest interview. It is used to bring the subject in the proper psychological position that will help the expert assess the hostile personality of the subject and prepare him for the detection. Next is questionnaire formulation. While questioning the subject, basic approaches are first, irrelevant questions. Irrelevant questions included because the answer to the questions are admitted truth. Second is control questions. They are not related to the crime but to a similar situation in which the answers may have a feeling of concern with respect to either its truthfulness or accuracy. A recent development in questioning technique is the use of questions on which the subject is directed to tell lie as a control question just to reveal the pattern of physiological response when a person tells a lie. And third one is relevant questions. These are the questions pertaining to the crime under investigation based on the fact of the cases. Some precautions should be taken while prepare questionnaire. Firstly, the questionnaire should be in the language the examinee is familiar with. Second, words used in the questionnaire should be directed and simple. Third, leading questions should frame to elicit yes or no answer. Fourth, one questionnaire include 10 to 12 questions. Now the next topic is examination. Familiarize the examinee with the examination room, polygraphic equipments. Second, instruct the examinee about the manner he has to be sit during examination. Third, attach the sensors on examinee. Fourth, record the normal physiological parameter after the sensor attached to the examinee. Fifth, instruct the examinee regarding the administration of questionnaire. Sixth, review of questionnaire with examinee just to ensure that he understood all the questions properly and to familiarize him with the questionnaire. So what is administration of questionnaire here? Administration of questionnaire is each questionnaire is administered in 3 times in a minute. While asking question, there will a gap of 25 seconds after each question in order to activate and normalize the sympathetic and parasympathetic components of automatic nervous system. Marking should be made on chart at the time of starting of questions and end of question and to indicate the responses of subject on chart. So, the analysis of polygraph chart. So in this, observe the normal reading of physiological parameters and then compare the recording of each physiological parameter on each relevant question with respect to normal reading or reading on control questions and recording or irrelevant questions. Then mark the reaction on each and every questions on the polygram. What are the limitations of the polygraph test? The first limitation is unresponsiveness of subject. Second, mental abnormalities. Third, some unobserved muscular movements, 4th, mental tension of subject due to offenses committed earlier, 5th, physiological defects like hearing impairment, etc., which interfere in proper administration of polygraph examination procedure. So, it is the end of the video, and to know what you have learned in this video, here is a question. And the question is, polygraph test violate which article? Option A, Article 26, and Option B is Article 20, Clause 3. You can drop your answers in the comment box below. And in our previous video, whose topic is Introduction to Medical Jurisprudence, we have asked a question which is, medical jurisprudence properly embraces all questions which affects the civil and social rights of individual and injuries to the person and bring the medical practitioner into the contact with option A, patient, option B, court, option C, hospital, option D, law. And the correct answer is option D, law. So I hope you find this video something interesting. So don't forget to like this video and subscribe the channel and drop your answer in the comment box. Thank you very much.